Before we start, I just want to let you guys know I did forget to do my intro. My daughter was literally like a bug, so I couldn't do my intro. Sorry for that.
Also, the music that is playing in the background is my boy's beats. He does a really good job. You should go follow his social media down below if you are interested.
And if you guys want to see this bomb ass look, just keep watching. I love you guys so much. If you're new, make sure you subscribe and like to this video. Love you.
What's up, guys? It's Loka back here with another lit ass video. So first things first, we're gonna do our eyebrows. So I decided to do this all step by step because there are some new products that I am using today. So I decided, like, you know, not to do a voiceover, to actually talk through my video. And I am very, very, very excited to use some of the products that I have here today. I am excited. Y'all don't even know. I've never used a lot of these products, so I am kind of liking it, you know. So I don't know if you guys seen most of my videos, but my true fans know that I always use this like little square thing in this palette. I'll pull it up. So I used to use this little palette thing, and I used to use this brown eyeliner in here for my eyebrows, and I'm finally out, and there's no reason for me to use this palette. The only palette thing I even use is probably like the black eyeliner, because I don't think I own black eyeliner. This is why I keep it. I decided to try something else. I didn't want to do the Anastasia pomade because, I mean, I don't have that much money right now and my budget is on a budget. I'm on a budget, okay? So I decided to pick up the e.l.f. We're going to be using this e.l.f. dip brow. It's like $4 at Walmart, legit. It's really nice and creamy, and it has not gone hard on me yet, so that's good.
It's finally here. You guys always been asking me to do a brow tutorial, and I never knew how to do a brow tutorial like without just filming myself and actually doing my brows. Like, I actually don't know how to explain how to do my brows, but here's a video on how I do them. Like I said, this e.l.f. dip pomade is really good. Usually pomade, like the Anastasia Beverly Hills pomade dip brow, it actually gets hard. It like really gets really, really, really hard after a while. If you leave it open for a little bit, it'll get really hard. And then I'd have to like melt it with my lighter. But with this, you don't. I haven't had no problems with it. And it's cheap. $4. Like, boo, go. It's a steal. Go get it.
Okay, guys, so I did my eyebrows and I did my contacts off camera. If you guys don't know what kind of contacts I am wearing, I did a whole video on them, so you could click that link to go check that video out to get you some contacts. And I do have a discount code in the description below on that video, so you can get 5% off on some contacts, okay? I'm not sure if it's 10 or 5%, but I'm pretty sure it's 5. We are going to be doing our makeup today, and I am so happy to be reviewing these eyeshadow products. Before we get into it, let's just do what we gotta do. Prime and prep our face. We are going to be using the Skin Serum, the VV, and Hello Sunshine. So it's like refreshing for your face. I put it on before I do my makeup always because I love how it feels. It doesn't feel oily when you put it on your skin. It's not oil, actually. I don't know what it is, but it leaves my face feeling so nice, and it's a really good primer as well. It makes your face feel like kind of tacky. I love the smell. It also has a smell, so if you guys are the people who don't like scents to your skincare stuff, because I do know that almost got it in my eye and it says don't get in your eye. The next thing I'm going to be putting on my face, this Lasting Finish 8-Hour Water. It's a makeup primer, obviously, but I've never used it before. It was on clearance, so I got it. I'm really not a primer person. I just need something that was gonna help my makeup stay real quick. And it doesn't really like, I mean, it works. I'm going to put that on the cheeks by my pores, and I'm just going to rub that in. I don't like to put it all over my face, but definitely where I want my makeup to stay. And I like to deepen my pores up with it. I am going to prep my lips with some beeswax. So now we are going to go right in and do these eyes. I'm going to be using my full wear concealer in the shade 325 Eggshell. It's pretty light, but I did pick me up an ivory one, so I decided to use this just for a base for my eyelids, and it works.
So now I'm going to grab one of my beauty blenders, and I got it from Real Techniques. You can get these anywhere, Walmart, Ulta, like they sell them anywhere. And I'm going to be blending my base out. So you want your base to have no cracks, no creases. So once you put your eyeshadow on there, it's just perfect.
Well, I am going to be using tape because I'm going to be using these pigment powders. I'm going to be putting these tapes on my eyes because I do not want any fallout whatsoever. Now, before we get in, I want to shout out Miss Boss Lashes. You can go check them out on Instagram, you guys. These are the best. Well, I'm not going to say that yet because I haven't tried them. But just by looking at them, like, dude, I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 different pigment shades. I don't know how you call these. What do you call these? Like, how do you say this? Anyways, I got a neon yellow, neon pink, dark purple. I got a neon electric purple, kind of like on the pink side in the middle of the purple. Like in between pink and purple, to a dark pink, like a regular pink, not a neon pink. Dark blue, which is so cute. Baby blue, lime neon green. You guys, look at this color. Lit. I got a neon orange, well, an orange, and I think this one's the neon orange. So I got 10 different pigment colors from them, and I've never used colors like that before. I've never used powder eyeshadow before, so I'm so happy to try this out with you guys. They also sent me three different types of glitters. They sent me this glitter. So that's like fallout, you put on your eyes and stuff with some glitter glue. They sent me a turquoise, a baby blue turquoise one. I don't know how to, I don't know like how to feel about these ones. I really don't. It's kind of just like glitter. But I don't know. I don't know why I don't feel like I'm gonna be a fan of these ones. But we're not gonna try these ones out today anyway. They also gave me another one like that. It's kind of like a lavender purple, kind of like. It looks, in person, looks like a really, really, really light purple that's mixed with some gray. I don't know how to use these, but whatever. They also sent me 3 pairs of lashes. 4 pairs of lashes, my bad. They sent me China lashes. So these are the China lashes. So cute. Look at this packaging. Adorable. They sent me Princella lashes, Stella lashes, which are really cute. And they sent me Honey lashes, which are my favorite. I've already tried them on so far. I really like them. We might be using these ones today. I kind of have pink on already. I did my nails, so I feel like using pink already. Let's just go in. Look at that. Like, I'm scared. Okay. Don't be scared, Jasmine. You got this. So, we're gonna go in with a brush. Of course. Like, what else? And we're gonna start by just placing it in the crease. So, I guess we're gonna go for a crazy look. I mean, these are crazy pigment shades, you know? they blend nice. I mean, they are setting really, really nice. They're not patchy, not that I can tell yet. Yet. Crazy pigmented. Look at it. Even while I'm blending it out so carefully, like, it is coming with me. Like, it's pulling away from the crease and actually blending for me. This is so nice, dude. And I'm not just saying this because I got they sent me their stuff to try out. And, like, you guys, this is amazing. You guys really have to go check them out. And they're very inexpensive. Oh my god, I'm so excited. I just want to pack it more so I could get more pigment. Can you guys see this? I feel like my lights are really dark right now. So I'm working on getting more light so you guys can fucking see me, okay? Oh my god, I'm so excited. I'm too excited for this. Oh my goodness, look at this pink. So I'm gonna do a cut crease and we're gonna go in with my Glam of, honestly, I never say it. It's from Hard Candy and it's some foundation, but I use it as concealer. I was not satisfied with how this was foundation.
So I'm going to go in with that neon yellow and I'm going to put that right in my inner corner. And as you can see, I started off way, way not in the inner corner. And here I'm shaking my head like, bitch, you forgot to put in the inner corner. But that yellow I just put right there is really supposed to be in the inner corner. And then we will be using orange on the outer corner. But look how pigmented this is. Look at that. It's crazy. As you can see, we're gonna move on to the neon orange and I'm gonna cover up that yellow that I did. Now, I don't know if you guys can pay attention, but this orange was really giving me trouble. The pink and, you know, the yellow was really nice, but for some reason, this orange was really, really hard to pack. It kind of came out patchy. But I ended up fixing it. You know, your girl fixes everything. Next, I am going to be taking my liquid eyeliner. And this one's from Maybelline New York. Honestly, I don't really know the real name from it. But all I know is from the company Maybelline. And it sucks. It sucks. Don't get it. If you see it, if you can see it in my hands. And if you see it at the store, bitch, don't get it. Because, like, I literally have to keep shaking this hoe to get product out of it. Like, nobody got time to keep shaking it. We gotta get the product out now. We gotta make this wing sharp now, boo, now. And I'm going to be putting my hair in a bun because now we're gonna move on to the face. And you know what that means? Foundation. Now the foundation I've been using is from Too Faced and I changed my shade the third. This is the last time I'm gonna change my shade. And at first I had the shade Swan. It was too light, too white, so I changed it to Snow. It was still so white for me. Now, I feel like this ivory color is my color. It has a tint of tan in it. It's not so pale. What do you guys think? Because I've been trying to find my color in this type of foundation because I love this Too Faced foundation and, like, I couldn't find it. And I really feel like this is my color. Y'all, please let me know. Let me know. So we're going to move in with our Cream Contour Anastasia Beverly Hills palette. And I do use the first two shades on the bottom, which is in medium and chocolate. And right here, I'm just going to bronze my face. You guys know there is nothing but a beat face if it's not bronze. Like, you got to bronze your face, you know? It's a must. Boss Dream Music. Concealer. Now we're going to move on to my concealer. I just said that twice. I changed my color to ivory. At first it was an eggshell, but you know, I had to go darker for my foundation.
And I love how this blends out. It's a full wear concealer. And I'm just going to bake my face after I'm done blending it out with my Dermablend Translucent Setting Powder. I love the setting powder. It does not have a flashback to it. So, yeah. So, we're going to move on to bronzer. And so far, I've been using the Milani powder. I love this bronzer. It's not so dark and it's not ashy. And you guys, it's so inexpensive. I got it from Walmart, you know. Now I'm going to go in with this BB palette I got from one of my stores I love to go to, and I'm going to grab that blush shade. I don't really use blush, but you know, I'm trying to be more girly. Everybody uses blushes nowadays, so I'm trying. And I'm going to cut the bottom of my cheekbones so I can make that really nice sharp line, because you know, after you bronze your face and you put blush on your face, everything's everywhere, so you just want to make sure everything looks intact and so nice and clean. We're gonna go in with my setting spray. It's called the Studio Series and it's matting setting spray. You know, we gotta set the face because I am a busy mom, so you know, a girl is running back and forth everywhere. Now we're going to use one of the highlights from that BB palette I just showed you guys, and we're going to highlight the bridges of my nose. We're going to highlight my cheeks, the sides of my nose, you know, like I say, we got to blind these niggas, period. Now we're going to use this lippy from L'Oreal. It's this brown kind of chocolatey shade, and I love it. It's liquid turned to matte, so it's cute. And we're going to go in with the Take Me Back to Brazil, and we're going to be using that yellow, orange, and pink, and we're going to go under our eye with it. And we're just going to top it off with some white and the waterline. You guys, I'm in love with this look. It looks really nice and tropical. It kind of reminds me of one of those birds with the colorful beak from like Fruit Loops. I don't know. I hope you guys like it. If you guys did, give it a thumbs up.
Okay, so before I'm done, I got this thing from Ulta, and it's the Morphe Jeffree Star Set and Refresh Mist and Strawberry Scent. And it's basically just a finisher, so when you're done with your makeup, you just spray it all over your face. And I did smell it and I tested it out at the Ulta, but not on my face. Obviously I didn't have anything, so I cannot wait to use it. It says directions: hold the bottom from 8 to 10 inches away from face, close eyes, and apply the mist all over your face. Here we go. Okay guys, if you guys like this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel. If you are new to the crew, I do a whole bunch of different things. Boo! I will put most of the products that I've used on my face in the description below. Until next time, I love you guys so much. And make sure you go follow them on Instagram to get all the pigment powders and their lashes, because they are so bomb. So, love you guys.